core ideas and cross-cutting concepts. The framework and the NGSS define big ideas that have explanatory power for making connections among ideas.
We want to think about questions.
Instead of memorizing facts, formulas, and procedures, the NGSS emphasized the usefulness of ideas in explaining phenomena, and especially in making sense of an unfamiliar phenomenon.
It's water because it takes the water.
These fewer big ideas in each discipline focus on a deepening of knowledge to allow students to make connections among ideas and across disciplines to mirror the way scientists approach the world. For example, a scientist could look at a rain event with a lens of patterns. Is this similar to other rain events? Or systems? Where are the inputs and outputs of the flow? Or cause and effect? How will the water affect the soil in this area? These are lenses that the teacher must make explicit for students who are learning to acquire the unique way that scientists approach phenomena.
That's the best way to make them aware is to see that, oh, someone may have just said something that is going to really help us understand.
How does a teacher, such as Molina, approach science so that students can think about patterns and cause and effect to discuss interactions between the Earth systems in an authentic way?
So they start out the day after a rain, and the students are just thinking about what is evidence. So scientists use evidence when they make claims, and this is kind of a new thing for a lot of kids, to think, I can say something, but it has to have evidence to back it.
What about footprints? We didn't see many of those yesterday. How about Alejandro?
I think it rained because wet footprints.
Because the wet footprints. Very nice.
The first day, the students show that they have a lot to build on, that they have a lot of ideas about what counts as evidence, and how you can determine if something is evidence of snow and rain.
We start with questions. Simple question, like, do we know that it snowed last night? What would the evidence be for that then? Yeah.
There's snow on the floor.
That we would have seen snow on the ground or not.
And on the trees.
And on the trees. There was snow on the ground. Anything else? Yeah.
Probably snowed in the morning.
And what would your evidence for that be?
It snowed a lot.
Because there might have been a lot of snow on the ground. I'm going to say a lot. How's that? Good. So then this would be our evidence. What we observed that made us think that, yes, indeed, it snowed.
The students do not mention the cross-cutting concept in their idea. Molina will want to prompt them to start thinking about using language that cues the lens of cause and effect, patterns, and systems. The cross-cutting concepts in the performance expectations.
The grass was wet because I think it was raining.
Muddy puddles, maybe it rained.
Molina supports the students through her prompts, cues, and questioning.
Right, so it dried, and then now again in the morning it's wet. And not only are the leaves and the trees and the grass wet, but Yadira's shoes were wet. And were they wet yesterday afternoon, let's say? Afternoon?
No.
No.
Students start with ideas that mud is evidence of rain because it is still wet. Many of them either focus on the evidence of actual water or the evidence of soil mixed with water. Next, the students talk about other kinds of evidence, like a river that water can carve into the earth over time.
Is that mud over here?
No.
What is that?
Water.
It's what?
Chips.
Can you say that really loud?
Chips.
Chips of what? What kind of chips?
What?
Chips.
Oh.
Molina uses a sorting activity and a discussion format to build the idea that you can find evidence of rainwater by observing the track it made.
Maybe they were digging a line, and then the water went and it was like a river.
Maybe someone hurt or hit were driving the bicycle, and then they made a line in the dirt.
Okay, so we have water you can see. Which ones belong in that category?
That one.
This one? What else?
This one.
That one.
This one, okay.
This one.
This one. And then these are the ones where you can't see the water?
Yeah.
I can kind of see this one.
The core idea becomes more sophisticated when the students observe and discuss rapid changes to the land with the help of a video of water and debris flow in Yosemite.
The ice will surge into place, and with enough thickness, it stops, and the creek will flow a different direction. The water will drain out of where it's just deposited it, leaving this what looks like snow. But you'll see this lava flow effect where the ice is going to accumulate and build up blockages that stop it from coming in a certain direction.
Notice that the students are using the cross-cutting concept of systems, or patterns, to help them think about the core idea.
So you see some evidence of water, maybe from the day before or the week before.
And Melina's cues help them make the connection.
In this one, there's change because the water brought these things, and then it got dry, and then the things were there, and then the land changed.
Have you ever seen that before?
Yeah.
Like you're sitting there looking, and you what do you see?
There's some things that the water comes, and then it comes to one of this, and then it goes down. But it brings plants sometimes, and then they get stuck.
The big ideas that students are working toward is that there are patterns that can help you think about changes to the land. Students are moving toward developing more complex ideas and coming up with rules that can guide future thinking in earth science. It takes time to incorporate cross-cutting concepts. Melina has come so far, and thousands of other teachers are on the same journey. Reflect and think about your own experiences and share them below. How are you asking questions related to the cross-cutting concepts in your own classroom?